Hey, Wildcats. You asked for it. It's another installment of Cooking with Tyler. Well, I said last time our next episode was going to be cheese cupcakes. Little did I know, cheese cupcakes are a real thing, apparently. Here's what you're going to need. 2 cups of all-purpose flour. You're gonna get some use. 2 teaspoons of baking powder. Got my old friend Clobber Girl here. Oh, Clobber Girl. Sorry, got her. We need 1 cup of sugar. We got sugar. 1/2 cup of softened butter. Oh, cool. 1 whole stick is 1/2 cup. Now my concern is that this recipe, I don't think mentions salted or unsalted butter, so this might taste kind of bad. I need 300 milliliters of condensed milk. I'm gonna have to do some measurements because this one doesn't say milliliters. And then we're gonna need 3 eggs, which I forgot to. I gotta go find the chicken and get some eggs. And then 1/2 cup. Plus 1/4 cup of grated cheddar. I like cheese, so I grated this myself, and I kind of thought the recipe said I needed 2 cups. I'm just gonna snack on this from time to time. I like cheese. We're also gonna need some cupcake liners. I was feeling kind of frilly today, so I thought I would go for the pastels. This should supposedly make 14 cupcakes. My pan can hold 12. So, I don't know if Sana has special pans, but. So, to start things off, you need to preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Now, your oven might have a button here. It's okay if it does. Mine doesn't, which makes it more efficient. Shh. Let that preheat while we get all of our kit and caboodles. Step one, after you preheat your oven, you're gonna get some cupcake liners. I got mine all sorted out. So this should be real nice fun time. Don't those look pretty? Okay. Let's see what's in here. Beat the butter and sugar together in a bowl of a stand mixer until fluffy while scraping the sides of the bowl if necessary. Okay. I got my bowl ready. I didn't bring out the stand mixer, so we're just gonna use this little boy. And look, I even went the extra mile. If you look inside, it's got a little guide. If you want to blend, you apparently need this weird. That was like a torture device. I shouldn't be left home alone. And don't worry, I'm just kidding. I'm gonna use a small bowl. I'm not dumb. We got 1 cup of sugar. That seems like a lot of sugar. And look, it's a fresh rock of cocaine. Now we need 1/2 cup of butter, which is, if you didn't know, usually they're marked. And see, one whole thing is 1/2 cup. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut my butter up. So I can just drop. And we're gonna beat the butter and sugar together in a bowl while Fluffy's scraping the sides. So it's been about 5 minutes and I don't think my butter was softened enough. This kind of looks more like mashed potatoes than fluffy butter. We're still at taters, so I'm just gonna go ahead and add in my eggs. There's one. And I guess I'm gonna start beating these bad boys in, and it's just, maybe the fluid will help. Maybe it'll make it more gooey. You know what? It's doing something. I think that is sufficiently blended. So now I gotta put 2 cups of flour in you and 300 milliliters of milk in there. And I don't know about you, but I'm kind of concerned that I don't have enough. I've never tried condensed milk. Yeah. So we're getting out of the edge. I hope if I scrape out the last bubble with a spoon, we can hit that 300 milliliters. If not, don't tell me, but I'm just going to add a punch of milk. We're heave holding for about 10 minutes. We got right there. We made it. Probably not a good idea to drink the condensed milk straight. This is my personal experience, because apparently you need every single drop. So, next, we're going to add 1/3 of the flour while this thing is working, which means I gotta put this down, because I don't have 3 hands. So aside from a mild spider incident, we're looking pretty good. Now we have to fold in 1/2 cup of grated cheddar, my 1/2 cup of cheese. Okay. And I'm gonna take a rubber spatula and just gently stir it in. And it's gonna gently fold. It's folding. Fold. It's gonna go hog wild. We're gonna put some more cheese in there. So keep on folding. I think that has been sufficiently folded. I get to be the big spoon today. We're gonna spoon the batter into the cupcake liners until they're 3 or 4. Alright, so, you know, considering Santa's little recipe was meant to make 14 little darling cakes, I don't have too much left over. I may try to save that for some. Supposed to be 3/4 full. I kind of went a little overkill, because again, I don't want to waste the batter. Instead, you're supposed to use the remaining 1/4 cup to garnish the top. I'm just kind of winging it. This might be a little too much cheese. And it could be that there's so much batter that it's just gonna overflow and make a huge mess. But you know what? I'm pretty sure they'll still get eaten. Here we go. There are my cheddar cheese cupcakes. We gotta open up our oven. Our little cakeys. There you go, cakeys. I don't wanna risk messing up my cake. Now, while they're cooking, comes the fun part. We just gotta clean up our mess. Thankfully, I got a little flour here. I just gotta rinse those, because they had flour in them. I gotta find a place to put that. And then I gotta, oh my god! Make sure when you're cleaning, you get all the little spots where you got a little excited and the beater just started beating. It's easy to make a mess when your beater's just going without thinking. It's always good to use your brain when you're using your beater. I don't know what I'm gonna do with that. I honestly have no idea. Uh-oh, look, we got some hidden beatings. There we go. No time at all. We got everything mostly clean. We got our dishes taken care of. I gotta let this guy soak, because he's got some cheese. Got 14 minutes. Oh, they're all they're already starting to overflow. We're in for it now. Whoopsie doopsie doo. I'll see you guys in 13 minutes. Oh, look at him! Look at him! Oh, this is amazing. They're puffing up. Puffing up both of the wrappers. Yeah. Those two in the back. Look at them. They're starting to smooch. I had to censor it because it's really graphic. These might actually turn out okay. I was skeptical. I'm also not wearing any pants. It's been about 30 minutes, honestly. They're looking mostly golden brown. I don't know what to do with that. getting golden brown. One thing to do is get a toothpick. Boom. We're gonna stick it inside. It comes out clean. Take another 3 or 4 minutes and that'll be good. Save me of glove. I don't wanna burn myself. While you're waiting for your cupcakes to cook, grab a little friend to play with, just to pass the time. Nibble, nibble, nibble. Nibble, nibble. All right, so I went ahead and pulled them out. Now they're looking pretty good. Got some nice edges, and they're a little golden brown. I'm gonna poke every last one of these little babies. It's always important to mark your babies, because otherwise, if you go to a park somewhere, you might get them mixed up. You don't know which kid's yours, so it's always good to mark your babies. We're gonna let cool and store leftovers in a covered... Look, yeah, they look like muffins. They look like muffins. Are these just gonna be cheese muffins? I don't like muffins. Oh, you know what? Make sure when you take your cupcakes out, you turn off your oven. That's important. It's also important to make sure you turn the light on higher if you're gonna start actually selling stuff. Got a little overflow, but you know what? I'm okay with that. I look like muffins. And my pastels, I'm so disappointed. You can't really make out the pastels. Which one's blue? Oh. We got a threesome over here. I can't tell which one's blue. Alright, well, let's try one of these puppies out. I'm gonna go for you. The edge has a bit of a crunch, but I don't mind a crunch. You know what? That's pretty good. I don't know if I call it a cupcake. It's definitely not a muffin. Oh, you're over there. Why don't you move over there? You get a little hint of the cheese taste, and it goes okay with the sweetness. I like it. That's pretty good. That went better than expected. So I gotta think of something to do next time. But anyway, I'll see you Wildcats next time. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a happy Thanksgiving if you celebrate it. Bye-bye.